Welcome back to Turning Hard Times into Good Times. I'm your host, Jay Taylor, and I'm really glad to have with me for the first time Nav Dhaliwal. He is the president and CEO of Bonterra Resources. He brings a wealth of entrepreneurial experience in sales and financing as well. He is particularly adept at nurturing early stage companies through their critical phases of evolution, having founded a number of companies over his career, and hence obviously very much the right man for the job for Bonterra Resources. It's a company that I've been following, but only recently did I put it in my newsletter recommending it about 2 weeks ago. The stock got away from me in the early days, but then with the ongoing success, it's continued to resonate with the investors, and for good reasons. Before I say hello to Nav, I want to just give you a little information on the company. The stock trades in Canada under the symbol BTR. You can buy it down here in the United States under the symbol BONXF. 161.8 million shares outstanding. And earlier today, and when I looked, it was selling in the United States in U.S. dollars at 45 cents, giving it a market cap of around U.S. 73 million, of course, taking it closer to 100 million in Canadian dollars. There's a lot of institutional holders here, and then prestigious names such as Kinross and Kirkland Lake. Van Eck Gold Fund owns some, and of course, the very well-known gold investor Eric Sprott is a major holder of the company as well. So welcome, Nav. I'm really looking forward to hearing what you have to say about your flagship property, Gladiator Project in Quebec. Very exciting, very high-grade results, and so just for the sake of mostly for lay investors that are out there, tell us, just explain what you've got going at the Gladiator Project, your resources and what we might look forward to in terms of ounces and grades and that sort of thing going forward.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me, Jay. So Bonterra is a company that's focused in Quebec, 170 kilometers northeast of Val-d'Or. It's called the Urban Berry Camp. Bonterra's, our focus here is proving out the resource that we started off with. We commissioned a 43-101 back in 2012. That resource was 200 meters at strike by 200 meters at depth. It came out with a 273,000 ounce at 9 grams a ton. So we knew that we were on to something here back in 2012. The company went through a transition of changing out management. You know, we needed to get people around us that have taken drilling holes into production and that kind of wealth. And having Dale Ginn as our VP of Exploration has really turned the corner on an area that is very active in Quebec. You know, taking us through that, here's where we are. We've taken a deposit that was 200 meters by 200 meters, and currently right now we have 1.2 kilometers strike by a kilometer at depth with multiple veins now. We have six zones officially drilled out. Earlier this year, we financed ourselves. So the company is well financed. And as you mentioned earlier, kind of turning over the roster with some well known people out there of the likes of Eric Sprott, Joe Foster, Kinross, Kirkland Lake Gold. So this year alone, we financed ourselves for over $40 million worth of bought deals. We've been actively drilling out there, and as you can see with the results that are happening, we haven't stopped working. We've had four drills consistently on the project. But more importantly, from what we've been doing on the deposit, we've been concentrating a lot on the deposit, but we've been doing some regional work. What's got us very excited is on our property, the Coliseum property, 6 kilometers away, we've hit a new discovery. So we're very keen on following up on that work, getting another 30,000 meters going for this winter. So in total now, the deposit has had 70,000 meters of drilling done on it. And we're ramping up. We've taken a 25-man camp, built it out to an 80-man camp. So we're really ramping up because the winter is a more efficient, is what I'd like to say, way about going about it. Getting on top of the deposit where the ground's a lot harder so we can move the equipment around And yeah, getting back to that Coliseum, we really want to, you know, 80% of our efforts are going to be put on onto the deposit, where 20% is going to go regionally with what we have found.
So unlike a lot of junior exploration companies in Canada in the winter, you're going to have, I suppose, some data flow, some drill results through the winter?
Absolutely, and that's where we really start, if you want to say, cranking it up, is, you know, we're that's our most efficient and economical way of going about it, because it is low-lying area, and when the ground does freeze up, like I was mentioning before, it's easy for us to get accessibility onto, you know, where we'd have to position ourselves. So we can work all year round, but we can really start making it a lot quicker during the winter season. And so we're getting ramped up and looking forward to it. So news flows wise, yeah, you know, from, call it from December to, you know, May of next year is really when we, you know, there's a high concentration of it. And again, we continue on throughout the summer. And, you know, we're looking forward to the winter campaign and coming out mid next year with an updated 43-101 on our deposit.
You have, I believe you mentioned you have something like 273,000 ounces, grading 9.37 grams. Is that the number, the right number?
Yeah, that's correct.
That's right now, grams, yeah. But that was up until when? That was up through 2015, or?
No, we commissioned that report in 2012. So we went through a transition where I took it over in 2012. I gave conception to Bonterra into the region. I just looked at the area and how management was looking at it, and I went in, took over the company, kind of cleaned it up, and making sense of all the drilling that was done in the past. They did one hell of a job, but we needed to make sense of that. So I commissioned a 43-101, giving us the 270,000 ounces and 9 grams, knowing it's a high grade. And, you know, from what we've accomplished so far, again, going back to that, is we've stretched it out to over 1.2 kilometers, a kilometer of depth. They're stacking up nicely. We look forward to getting some more drilling done here this winter to come out with a new 43-101 mid next year. That's our aim.
And the winter drilling will be expansionary or infill, or what? Can you characterize the nature of it?
Yeah, absolutely. There will be a portion that we are definitely going to concentrate on the infilling of the deposit to make sure that, you know, we've got the pierce points that that are going to be able to add to this 43-101, so the spacing's proper. But we also, as we, like, take for instance this summer, as we were moving the rigs back to get to the deposit, we found a new zone. We found a new north zone. We found a new south zone. So this, we haven't closed this deposit off in any direction. One thing that I'd like to emphasize, the company's never been in a better cash position, nor the geological understanding of what we're drilling into. The success rate that we're having at the end of the drill bit, really, I got to get hats off to the teams, the geologists that are running the drills and running the programs out there. They have a very strong, enthusiastic understanding of what we're drilling into and the system that we have.
Yeah, I sensed that when I spoke with Dale Ginn recently, your head geologist there. So let me understand this now. I think you said that initial resource is from a 200 meter by 200 depth, 200 meter strike, 200 meter depth. Did I hear you to say that it's 1.2 kilometers by 1 kilometer now?
That's right, as of right now. Yeah.
So we should be looking, and when might you have an updated resource then?
We're aiming for mid next year. Now, again, we plan on doing 30,000 meters of, and again, that's all success based. We start seeing that, we may increase it. We're comfortable in our cash. We look to spend about, anywhere from $8 to $10 million in this winter program. We're very comfortable with our treasury. So, if we start finding success, that's why we built out the camp to the size we have. If we need to expand it, we will expand it. So we really want to take the information that we're going to gather this winter and just add it to the 43-101. There's enough that we have here that a lot of people are looking at it. And here's the thing, a lot of with the results and how we're putting it out there, people that understand the geology of this area are really putting it together and see that the continuity is there. So We feel comfortable where we're at right now, but we really would like to add that 30,000 plus meters that we're going to be doing this winter to really give it a solid number coming out mid next year.
Boy, I would guess we should be, given, you know, just eyeballing some of the numbers that's been coming through in your press releases. any metallurgy done? Any metallurgy done yet, Nev?
Actually, that process has started as of now. So that metallurgy, that's all part and parcel of the process. So yes, it's started now and we'll continue on. Because we want to make sure that as we put this thing, advance the project, that, it's great that we're discovering what we're discovering, but we want to make sure that as the process is done properly as well.
Sure.
So
sure.
That when it comes time to looking at this deposit, great, but, how is it on the mineable scenario? And it's very mineable, as Dale Ginn has, with over 30 years of experience drilling these kind of deposits and putting them in production, that's what's got him very excited.
Nav, we're looking at an underground situation here, I suppose, given the grades, right?
Absolutely. It would be an underground situation, for sure.
Right, right. And good mining widths with those grades, I presume.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. The mining widths are there. It's all the ingredients are adding up to for one hell of a deposit here as well.
Yeah, no wonder there's some people quite interested, and you've got the likes of Kirkland Lake and Kinross and people very interested. You do have another project that looks quite good, actually, although it's not your focus now, but you have the Larder Lake project in Ontario, right across the border, right? Could you comment just briefly on that, perhaps?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Larder Lake project was something that we picked up in early 2015. You know, seeing that the way the markets were, Dale and myself were like, we've got a significant land package in the Urban Berry Camp, and looking outside of that, we needed a secondary project, and we found this Larder Lake package that consolidates three different deposits together. So you got a 4-kilometer strike, we found a distressed company that we were able to negotiate. We bought 1 million ounces on the books in the inferred category, a little bit in the indicated, about 50,000 in the indicated, for just over $4 an ounce in the ground. Mm. So it was very lucrative for our shareholders. Goldfields had did an option on this back in 2012 for $40 million. They left behind just over $6 million worth of work that we've started to compile the data and get this thing drill ready. As, we've raised the money this year, for the focus is our Quebec property, but it's not hurting us seeing that we own the grounds outright. That's very important for us as well, that there's no work commitments that we have to keep doing year by year by year, so that was important. That came with that package was that we own the ground outright, so it is definitely value add for our shareholders, and when we find it suitable for us, we will advance our project as well.
Nav, with just a minute or so left, I noticed that your shares hit, I guess you even told us that a few minutes ago, hit an all-time high today. So what would you say to investors that say, oh gosh, I missed the boat?
No. We're very pleased on the performance of the stock. Absolutely not. If you look at the value of what we're proving out as a deposit, comparatively to our market capitalization, I believe this is value, speaking loudly to investors to be taking, positions with a company, after they do their due diligence and again, look at what we've been putting out. Look at how this deposit's growing. I believe that this is just the start of a lot of great things to happen.
All right. Well, certainly I'll be keeping an eye on it for sure, and for my subscribers, and hope to pick up some shares. But I guess I better move quickly, perhaps, because anyway, thanks so much, Nav, for being with us.
Absolutely.
It is an exciting story, no doubt about it. And I know and think very highly of your chief geologist there, Dale Ginn. So look forward to talking to you again sometime in the not-too-distant future.
Absolutely. I'm looking forward to it as well. Thank you so much, Jay.